Hey, I was going to do today's new bit of work. You'll need a wall, a chair, maybe a soft mat. Depends on how the nail as you are. We'll start with three rounds. We'll start with three rounds, 1 minute calf stretch on each leg. Then we're going to go three rounds, we're going to do glute exercise, glute stretch, and then we're going to open up our chest, shoulders, and lats. I'm going to do that one three times. So 15 minutes total. Knee in, I tap my pelvis underneath, squeeze my glute. If you've already done today's session, probably for those quads. Seconds. Hopefully we're getting better here. If you've been doing it every day, perfect. Come on, let's change your legs. Some days you just don't want to do it, so you do it, don't you? Some days you're tired. Guess what? You're still going to be fucking tired whether you do or don't do it. You might as well do it. Change your legs. If you go find out when pound for pound is, so you're stuck into that column. Hopefully one day we'll have enough for you guys. We'll do sit together, banging.
He's lovesick. He's having a tantrum, refuses to do anything.
Change your legs. back towards the wall. Trying to get a point of discomfort, push a little deeper, and just get a tiny bit of progress. At the last minute, so we're going to take your chair, bed, box, your bed, whatever it is, and place our leg at a 90 degree angle. Should use a bench if it's softer. Okay, so make sure that my ankle and my knee are in line. I'm going to bring my chest forward. I'm going to put my bum backwards. So I sink my bum down, I open up those glutes. I don't want to be twisted. You don't want to twist, you twist into it, you don't want to be twisted away to get it easier. If you can't get down there, you can just push down on your knee. And another regression would be to take a seat, place your foot down, push that knee down, and raise it up that way. Then flip around. Change your legs. Oh, and if you're much tight on one side, that can be contributing to some back pain. Also, that's going to be affecting how we lift, how we squat, how we deadlift. I'm obviously much tighter on this side. Subs up, straighten the arms. Tight and do those deadlifts. If I can push through it, these trainers stink, like my head's right next to it. into his legs. So I definitely need to, after this, do an extra few minutes on this side. It's all messed up. Good, 10 seconds. So like I said, it's just 15 minutes. Even if you just randomly do it, you know, like you get up in the morning, you start the day with a bit of mobility, it's gonna help you. Because the optimal time is the time you can do it. It's not like the scientific way, because if you wait for that time and you can't do it, and you haven't done it, then it wasn't the fucking optimal time. Do some stuff on our hips later this week. Back qualifier in a minute. One more time, three. And down. Seconds and change the legs. So sometimes once I've eaten the time so that we're not pulling them out, which you definitely would be more mobile than I am right now. And if you're not as mobile as I am, well, you're fucked. No, do the videos. Get cracking, if you get time, do some extra work, do some foam rolling. Get in for a sports massage. Cold elbow jump in the back. Sophie. And I'll come back. And chest through. Good, and relax. Well done, guys.
Have a nice day.